Look up. Beautiful. Look down. There's an angle.
Bonjour, mon ami. Wow, we're really working on that French accent of yours. We hope this is better than the last episode, though. Anyways, today we're going to take up the angles of elevation and depression. Now, doesn't that sound like fun? Yup. You see, everywhere we look, up or down, an angle is formed. That is what you call angle of elevation and depression. But what do the angles of elevation and depression really mean? Let's ask the big book of trigonometry. Yeah! Oh, that's heavy! Let's see. Angle of elevation and depression. Elevation is the angle of vertical plane to the local horizontal and descending lines from the observer to an object, as you see from Mr. B and so on, also known as ascending vertical elevation angle. Whereas depression is the angle of the vertical plane between the horizontal and descending line, also known as depression angle, descending vertically on the minus angle. But I wanted to read from the big book of trigonometry. Do you get to give the meaning understandable by human mind? Well, you see, the angle of elevation of an object as seen by an observer is the angle between the horizontal and the line from the object to the observer's eye. Now this part here is the angle of elevation. Now if the object is below the level of the observer, then the angle between the horizontal and the observer's line of sight is the angle of depression. Now wasn't that easier than the one I just read from that stinking big book of trigonometry?
What's in the script?
It is now.
That's what they call ad-libbing, but don't tell our writers, okay?
Now that you've been introduced to the angle of elevation, angle of elevation and depression, we're going to apply this in our daily lives! Yay!
A man on a boat is 120 meters from a lighthouse and finds that the line of sight to the top of the lighthouse is 60 degrees above the horizontal. Find the height of the lighthouse.
Now, using the concepts of the 30-60-90 special triangle, we can deduce that the height of the lighthouse is the length of the side opposite the 30-degree angle, multiplied by square root of 3.
From a balcony 2 feet from Romeo, the angle of depression is 40 degrees. What distance separates true love?
Because the horizontal is perpendicular to the height of the triangle, the angle adjacent to the angle of depression is 50 degrees. Then, using sine law, we can determine the distance between Romeo and Juliet. X over sine 90 degrees is equal to 2 over sine 50 degrees. Since sine 90 is equivalent to 1, x equals 2 over sine 50 degrees. Using a calculator, x equals 2.61 feet.
The Eiffel Tower stands at an approximate height of 900 meters. If a man standing a distance away from the tower holds a 1,000-meter rope to the tip of the Eiffel Tower, find the angle the rope makes with the ground.
Here we can apply sa ka toa. Particularly the sine of theta equals the measurement of the side opposite the angle, over the measurement of the hypotenuse. Using a calculator, theta equals 64 degrees 9 minutes and 29.04 seconds.
If Patrick Star is on the top of a 15 square root of 2 meter tall Christmas tree, and the angle of elevation of SpongeBob SquarePants to Patrick is 45 degrees, how far is SpongeBob from Patrick?
Using the concepts of the 45-45-90 special triangle, we can deduce that the length of the hypotenuse is equivalent to the length of the given leg, multiplied by square root of 2. So x equals 15 square root of 2 times square root of 2. X equals 15 times 2. X equals 30 meters. Therefore, SpongeBob is 30 meters away from Patrick.